Now let's see how well this works when we have something like a branch that is just always taken. In that case, the entry for that branch will just be all ones in the history. That branch has a fixed PC. It always has the same history. When we XOR them, we will be using only one 2-bit counter. So pretty much, although we have a long history, if the branch is just a repetition of the same thing, we are ending up using only one of the 2-bit counters. So the additional cost relative to just having an array of 2-bit counters is that now we are keeping an 11-bit history for this branch. So still the cost is not just 2 bits, it's really, let's say, 11 or 16 bits plus 2, but it's much less than a long history plus 2 to the nth times a 2-bit counter. If we have a branch that is never taken, we can do the same reasoning and end up using a single counter. If we have a branch that has something like NTNT, it really has only two possible histories, 010101, etc., or 101010, etc., so it ends up using two counters. So if we have a lot of these counters, as you can see, most branches are going to be like these. We will be using very, very few entries by these branches, which leaves us plenty of counters for branches where we have a very long pattern, where we will be using something like, 16 histories, and thus use something like 16 counters. As you can see, in this organization, pretty much the branches that need more counters get them. The branches that need relatively few counters get them. The only really additional cost relative to just having the counters is the histories. The downside is that, again, some branches with particular histories might overlap in which counter they use with other branches and other histories. Pretty much my branch XORed with its history might map to the same counter as some other branch and its own history when they are XORed. But this happens very rarely if the BHT is large, and now it can be large because each entry is just 2 bits.